Gwizdala, it's videobasedlessons.tv, and following on from our most recent course on videobasedlessons.tv, which was a 12-week crash course in harmony, I'm putting together this 12-week vocabulary building course, which we're about to launch in a few days, and this is the first of 4 free preview videos to that course. We had so much positive response from the members at videobasedlessons.tv, so if you're a member and you're watching this, thank you so much for all your comments, all your suggestions. That has absolutely led to me putting this vocabulary building course together. And a 12-week crash course in harmony really only scratched the surface of the basics. So I perceive this as being volume one of our vocabulary building course, because I reckon there are going to be so many more things that I want to put into 12 weeks that there just won't be space for. So consider this the beginning of volume one of vocabulary building. What you heard me just doing was working a very simple idea, and simplicity is the name of this game for now. I want to build up your practice routines and build up your basic understanding of harmony and of how to apply that harmony and that vocabulary to changes. I want to build that up from the ground up, really give you an amazing foundation. No matter how advanced you are as a player, or no matter how much of a beginner you are as a player, I want to draw upon some of the simplest things known to us, such as a major scale, which is almost exclusively what I was using there to navigate through a 2-5-1 in the key of G. We have a simple A minor 7 in its kind of most basic form to D7 to G, 2-5-1. I'm sure most of the people watching this are going to be able to understand that it's a 2-5 going to a 1 in the key of G. And I was really restricting myself. This is a major part of my practice routine, is to restrict myself to certain elements, just so that I can force myself to be as musical as possible using only the fundamentals of the harmony. Of course, we're going to expand upon that. In this sequence right now, there's literally only a 2, a 5, and a 1. There's no 6 chord, for instance, or no E7 in this case going back to the 2. So it's really a basic 2-5-1. And I did start to add some of those flavors in towards the end of that improvisation just now of the 5 chord, of the 6th chord, the dominant 7th chord, the E7 going back to the 2 minor of A. I did start to hint at that, but really the purpose of this video, this preview, this little introduction to this course, is to show you how effective you can be with the most basic elements of harmony. And like I said, super pro, gigging every night, super advanced player, intermediate player, or complete beginner, it doesn't matter who you are, what you do watching this video, all of this applies. I guess I would consider myself an advanced player, if only for the fact that I've been doing this for so long. And I'm still searching through this. I'm still searching through the absolute minimum, the absolute most simple ideas I can possibly find. I'm still searching through them to come up with new ideas. So you're going to find we talk a lot about phrasing, we talk a lot about time, we talk a lot about sound, even though this is a vocabulary building course. And to get into your practice routine right now, I want to give you an exercise, something I work on a daily basis all the time. I want to give you an idea, a little concept that you can build 2-5-1 ideas in any key. We're doing it in the key of G here. You can build 2-5-1 ideas, pretty much an infinite number of 2-5-1 ideas. If you started to write them down as you develop them, I would challenge you to run out of ideas. I guess that's the challenge. I challenge you to run out of ideas, because with this tiny concept, you shouldn't be running out of ideas, because it's pretty much limitless. So let's get our loop going here. We have the 2, the 5, and the 1. And I'm going to restrict you, as I'm restricting myself, as though I've given you a homework assignment right now, I'm restricting myself to just G major. And no Lydian, no fancy flap 55K X dominant diminished or any of that. Literally just G major. Those are the only notes I'm going to use to improvise over this 251. So with that in mind, one of the things, the immediate things that the jumps to mind is the fact that, okay, it's very simple harmonically speaking, so we're going to have to be pretty creative rhythmically speaking. Vocabulary is not just harmony, it's not just notes, it's not just licks, it's so much to do with rhythm and so much to do with how you develop simple rhythms throughout harmony. I must also say, you're going to be more successful with this. This isn't a course about transcription, but you're going to be more successful at this and have a better rhythmic palette and a better melodic palette, a better all-round improvisational palette if you twin this exercise and twin these ideas with transcribing, with stealing, with ripping off licks from records, with going and finding solos that you're passionate about and that inspire you, and taking that information and playing those licks, playing, you know, I can't remember when it was so long ago that I transcribed that 251 lick, and it is a lick, and it helps me. In fact, that, well, we use that as an example. We use that as a rhythmic example and as a shape example, an example of how I took a transcription of somebody playing that. Maybe it was Dexter Gordon, maybe it was Charlie Parker, and how I'm going to use my concept that I'm about to explain to you of rhythmic development, using only a G major scale. Let's put those two together and show you how that can work. So my lick was 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and very simply to explain the lick to you, I outlined the chord tones of A. So it started G, E, C natural, and A natural. Then I managed to hit the third of the five chord, and then there were two, let's just call them passing tones for now, because I really want to get honed in on just using G major. There's an F natural and an E flat, so, and it basically leads down to the fifth of G of our root chord. And then the only two notes that are outside of G major were the F natural and the E flat. And we'll get to those further in the course. I'll explain what chord scales those are coming from, why they're there, and how they're used. But for now, it was really about just taking the idea of that lick that I transcribed probably 20 years ago at this point, and how we're going to apply it to this concept for today's video, which is taking small rhythmic ideas and only using G major. I'm pretty sure that everyone watching can play a G major scale. So what I want to do is take the element of thought and kind of that disconnect where you have to start thinking about harmony and all, which notes are in this scale and which chord. No, it's just G major. So you can be pretty loose in terms of the thought process for the tonality. You really don't have to think about it too much as long as G major is in your vocabulary. It's really about getting these rhythmic ideas together and developing small phrases. Now, we've restricted ourselves to G major, first of all. So now the next restriction I'm going to give you is to restrict you to three note phrases, just chunks of three notes. So I don't want to hear, endless lines of eighth notes, just a rhythmic phrase of three notes. So now I have to come up with one. I'm just going to listen to the loop for a second. It could just be three eighth notes like that. Da da da, ba ba ba, ba ba ba, ba ba ba. That's pretty simple. And only playing the notes within G major. And it sounds something like this. 1, 2, 1, 2, ding, dum. And I added a note there. Okay, so already it's tough even when you've been doing it a long time to really restrict yourself to the three notes, because already I naturally want to develop that, and I added a fourth note. But that's the general direction we're going in anyway. It's not just going to stay restricted to three notes, and the more comfortable you are, the more fluent you are with it, the more you're going to be able to expand it. I just want to get away from the safety net of only playing eighth notes. So as cool as that might sound sometimes, you know, just playing eighth notes, it can end up being a little bit monotonous, and it can end up being kind of a safety net as well. And doesn't really promote phrasing, and doesn't promote leaving space or very much rhythmic interest. If you're playing the same rhythm, you're at the same dynamic rhythmically speaking. So I hope you're beginning to see, just with this one scale and these three notes that I've tried to restrict myself to, and I hope you're trying to do the same thing, that you have now just an infinite number of possibilities and combinations and vocabulary building ideas that you can put into your playing. So I'll make examples of a few of them. We had three notes, why not four, for instance? So B-do-do-da, B-do-do-da, and these are just four eighth notes in a row. There's not even any break within the eighth notes, and already we have two concepts. So four notes, So, and I'm starting off simple. It's not going to turn into the most musical thing right away. But giving you an example now, I'm going to give you an example now of something where it's not just continual eight notes for four notes. So, bims, be do do da. How about that? Bam, ba da do da. Bam, ba da do da. That's a new rhythm. One, two, on, two, three. Whoops. It'd help if I pressed the started the loop in the right place. But whatever. Bam, ba da do da. Bam, ba da do da. Zom, ba da do da. Zom, ba da do da. And maybe I felt like I needed to make there be a little less space between the phrases. But and what did I have there? I had. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to leave space on the downbeat rather than all of these ideas happening on the beat. I was leaving a quarter note and starting the idea on two. One. Rest. 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 Just restricting myself or ourselves to three notes, four notes, leaving a rest on the downbeat, I'm starting to develop more interesting phrases, phrases that are definitely phrases, they're not a continual line of eighth notes, and I'm still just using G major 7, and I'm completely navigating through this set of changes. So if I were to put something in the looper where there was not just one 2-5-1, where we had multiple 2-5-1s, so how about we go from, how about we take the G, so now we have two 2-5-1s, I'll put a backbeat in there. There we go. So now all we do is we have two major scales instead of one. We have our G major for the G251, and we have F major because we went down a whole step to the F251, and the concept stays the same. So the reason I'm showing you this two tonal centers now is that so much jazz harmony is made up of a sequence of 2-5-1s and different key centers. Even if you take a song like Giant Steps, the second half of Giant Steps is a bunch of conventional 2-5-1s in three different key centers. Of course, Coltrane had his 2-5-1 kind of extended harmonic function in the first eight bars, And we'll get to that later on in the course. I love that way of thinking about 251s, a Coltrane kind of giant steps method, giant steps countdown, that kind of sound. So for a song, the second half of giant steps, which actually sounds fairly complex, if you're playing an E flat, and then you're going to G natural, and then you're going to B. So you have these three key centers. You have E flat, G, and B. But with this new technique, or not new technique, with this very simple concept I'm explaining to you, you can really get through those key centers with just a major scale in each of the root keys. And that's what this kind of displays here. So we have G, now F, back to G, F. Back to G. F. So all of those ideas. Now, maybe perhaps you can hear, perhaps you can't. Maybe it's going to take some time, but I hope you can hear that it's starting to get, we're starting to get even more in depth with the phrasing. I'm kind of rushing through it a little bit because this is just a preview video for the course, and we're going to get into depth how I went from just three notes to making some of these. How I went to making a little more complex sounding, a little more maybe even bebop sounding lines. But still, the overall concept is that we're still only using a major scale, and we're not using any outside notes from that. It's all about phrasing. It's all about rhythmic development. And all of this leads into giving you more vocabulary and also more things for you to populate your practice routine with. With all the things we're going to cover just in the next four free videos, and never mind the 12 videos we have for our 12-week vocabulary building course, these videos should populate your improvisational and your vocabulary practice routine for the rest of your lives. They've populated my routine for the last 20 years, and they continue to do so. I strongly believe that I will literally never run out of things to practice, and it's because of simple concepts like this that I can populate my practice routine with that makes that a reality. So, I'm Janek Gwizdala. It's videobasedlessons.tv. I'll see you again tomorrow or in a couple of days on our next free preview video for our brand new 12-week vocabulary building course.